What is good, YouTube? It's your boy Meltnificent coming back with another sneaker review. Now, today I'm kind of excited because I'm kind of thrilled to actually get this shoe. Not too much in advance, but it's kind of like it releases tomorrow at 10 o'clock. The PG3 50th edition, the NASA edition, that features, or actually is commemorating the Apollo 11th mission where the first man landed on the moon. Take that for what you want, but that's why this shoe is pretty much silver. It's a 3M reflective shoe. And from what I read, it's supposed to be reflective on the eyelets of the shoe and on the mesh, which is featured on the, I believe, the side panels and the toe box. So, kind of curious to see this. Now, before we get any further, before I do the unboxing, thank you for joining me. And if you can, subscribe and like the channel. You know me, subscribe to me. I will subscribe to you. But before we get to the box, I really want to actually pull this out because there's something about this shoe that makes this review a little awkward. Let's just review something real quick. So I got the PG3 NASA's, the ones that released to commemorate the Apollo 13 mission. This remove before flight tag right here. You got to remember what those numbers, remember there are numbers on the back right here. Remember these numbers? This is going to make this kind of awkward, simply because in the off season, we all know what happened with, Paul George, but, it's just a little bit of details. I'm not sure anybody thought about it, but for those that don't know, if you've seen these PG3 NASA's, you know, it says, let me move this out the way. It says remove before flight, but it also has additional numbers on the back. So I already reviewed this on the white and gold version that released, the white and gold NASA's, but I'll say it again. So let's review this. We look on the tag, and the first number that you see right here, 661. That's the area code of Palmdale, California, where Paul George was born and raised. And I believe they have like a NASA camp within that area. So, you know, PG3, he was a, Paul George, was a big, you know, NASA fan, right? So we look, let's just go straight to the next number. All right, so that's 1990. Now, 1990 was the year Paul George was born. The issue I have, not really issue, but the awkwardness is the last set of numbers right there. You see that? Reads 405. Yeah, that's let's get into the shoe, then I'll reveal why this is awkward. So without further ado, finally the unboxing of the PG3 50th version NASA commemorating the Apollo 11 mission. Now, for those that are wondering how did you get this or ahead of time, no, I didn't go to StockX. Finish Line actually had I believe it was a Tuesday offer where you could get it for, I believe it was for their early access customers. And I just so happened to get that email. I'm pretty sure I didn't get the special box, but, you know, I still got the shoe a day ahead of the actual release date, which is tomorrow, which is the 20th. And it should be on the sneakers app, I think, like around 10 o'clock. So let's get this thing. A shout out to Finish Line for getting this to me this quick, because I really didn't expect to get this that quick. And actually, I can see that the box already, I can tell the box is not the special edition, knock on wood. So let's take this out. There you go. There's the Finish Line. Thank you for purchasing, blah 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 blah. And nothing was damaged when I did that, but anyway. So, if you look here, it's your standard NASA PG3 box. Comes with the PG3, actually the PG logo on the front. And you can see that also this NASA version has also the QR code, that RFID chip. For those that haven't seen it in my previous video, I revealed what is below underneath this sticker. You will see the radio frequency identification. RFID is what translates to. I have my personal pair, size 13, that you're reading right there. And of course, the box, the top of the box, it has that Paul George, pretty much name, in Palmdale, California, as I said, where he's from. Now, enough talking, let's get in the shoe. Now, keep in mind, you will have that zoom in technology. You will have this right here, this macro, the macro version, which means I'm going to zoom in on this shoe, magnify. I'll give you we're going to do the on-feet review, but I'm going to give you another view where everything is just enhanced, magnified, not to be seen in the naked eye. And I know you're like, shut up, just get into the shoe. Ladies and gentlemen, and it's just the way I predicted in my previous video. This is the PG3 50th edition, NASA's, and this is dope. This is dope. Now, let me pull the other one out. Ah, there it goes. There it goes. For those that are wondering, it does have that remove before flight tag. If you're wondering what I did, let me bring out the other shoe, which actually is right here. All I did was remove that tag. You look at the location of the stock pair. You see that they attach some plastic little string right there. But I removed that, the key string, relocated it to the strap on the tongue so it's not, you know, hanging pretty much below. I covered that as well on the white and gold. But that's that version. Let's look at this version. Now, for those that aren't sure or don't remember, the white and gold version featured that gold swoosh. Now, this is more of a silver metallic swoosh on the midsole, which I think is dope. But I know you see it. I purposely did it this way. So let's go back to those numbers and we'll kind of review it again, right? So 661, area code for Palmdale, California. 1990, the year Paul George was born. So that leads us to the last set of numbers. 405. Anybody want to take a guess what 405 is, what it stands for, what it means? Well, for those that don't know, if 661 is the area code for Palmdale, California, what is the area code for 405? No, literally, what is the area code for 405? Oklahoma City. Whew. Awkward, because he plays for the Clippers now. So that's why I was wondering about this. There's one thing I was thinking about when I saw, I remember these shoes. Remember, I did a review on both shoes. I did the white and gold. I did the original version. And now I'm doing the reflective, the PG3 NASA reflectives. And that was the one thing that I was curious about to see if they were going to have that tag on there. Because 405 is OKC. And we all know that, you know, your boy Paul George got traded from OKC. He is now in LA with the Clippers with Kawhi Leonard. Awkward. Anyway. With that said and done, let's get straight into the shoe. So now I see off the back, I was going to look at the heel of the shoe. Because on the heel in the originals, looks like they relocated everything again. So if you look on the first version where it has the Apollo 13 tag on the heel, as well as the NASA tag on the other heel, being the, if I'm looking at this right, this will be my left. Right? Looks like they switched it up on the PG3 50th version. They did the NASA, right, imprint on the heel. This is all stitched. And then they did this PG, this is kind of new. This is a stitching that I've never seen on any of the NASA versions. It looks like they did the PG around the world type thing. So that's interesting. But it's not featured on any other NASA versions that we had before. Now, I was trying to locate the Apollo 11 tag, which I see that they put on the tongue, on the left side of the tongue, for this shoe. Now, keep in mind, for those that didn't see it, of course you'll see it on the Superzoom version, but I like to point it out right here. On the tongue of the shoe, there you go, Apollo 11, which I think is dope. And also on the inside of the shoe, on the tongue, you got your QR. Make sure when you scan that QR, the numbers that are on that QR should pop up in the web browser when you go to, it should take you automatically to Nike.com QR or something like that, slash with a bunch of numbers. But going back to the shoe, like this portion right here, and you, again, you'll see this in a 3M video. The mesh portion on the toe box is reflective. The side panels right here is reflective, as well as the other side, which is also reflective. The part that a lot of people may or may not know is that the eyelets, these three, are also reflective on both sides. So when we do that video to review the flash or whatever, and we're looking at it from behind my camera with the flash on, you should be able to see the reflective design in this. Now, I don't know if the tongue itself is reflective. May not be the case. It looks like the tagging on this obviously would not be reflective. But again, I am pleasantly surprised that this shoe came a day early and your boy got them in hand. These 3M reflectives, PG3, these reflectives are nice. I mean, I like the concept. I like the idea of teaming up with Nike and coming up with, you know, the whole Apollo to commemorate the Apollo 11th mission by designing a shoe that kind of structured with the whole moon phase, if that makes sense. Because in theory, you could say that, oh, okay, like this, even though this is featured on these shoes, you could say like, okay, maybe these could represent like the moon circle things that you step on when you're up in the air and you're in the moon and the surface of the moon. You could kind of say that that's what this is. And I think that's what represents on the Zoom heel portion. That's not the heel, the upper foot of the shoe, which I mean, it could represent it, but that's the Nike Zoom right here. Man, I just can't believe I got this shoe a day early. I think this is pretty dope. So, but anyway, going back to the shoe, that famous saying, don't tell me that the sky's the limit when there are footprints on the moon. Obviously, this being the moon color, you can see that on the heel, represented all the way around. You will get, again, you'll see this in the Super Zoom version. And actually, so you're probably going to see a couple of clips. The first clip you're going to see is the video clip, a short video clip of the 3M and how it pops. Then you're going to see the Super Zoom version. And then you're going to see me with these on feet walking around. Whew, man, so excited right now. So excited. Now, for those that are wondering what happened to my white and gold NASAs, unfortunately, boy, I had to part ways with them because somebody was really, I mean, like really, at my neck for getting those shoes. So I had to part ways with them. But I'm glad that I got the originals. Kept the originals. These are not dead stock awardees. And now I can finally put second NASA back into the collection because honestly, I like this version. This, you would think that it's just too much silver, but the fact that this is not a, it must be the, actually, this must be like the week of cool gray releases, because the Jordan cool gray, that it was not the official release date, but the theme seems to be gray. I do have, let's see, the gray that are on the cements. I wanted to see how close the grays were. So if we, there's the Jordan 4 cements, and I wanted to show you kind of the hue of the gray. The hue of the gray is actually a gray that you can wear with a lot of things. Like that's the benefit of having a shoe like the black cements, where you could pretty much wear this with anything. Put that back in here. But this hue, it's not too far off. The hue of this gray is not too far off, whereas you can't wear it with certain things. Like I could wear this with my Nike pants right here. These are my Nike joggers. I could easily pull this off, and it's like a dead match with anything I put on. Even I can put that with my shirt. You know, so that's the benefit of having these type of hues. Now, it's not the same gray all around. I think it's a little bit darker on the mesh in terms of the gray design, but when you look at those tongue overlaps on the side right here, it's a little bit brighter. I don't think that this portion is 3M, but I'm pretty sure that the only thing that should be reflective on this shoe, again, is the toe box, side panels, and actually should wrap all the way around. And from what I can tell, it's got to be the eyelets, because it has that 3M kind of material that you would normally see. Like this hat is actually 3M, but it's, the build is pretty much the same. So with all that said, blah, 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 all done. I did say that. Let's just get straight to the next video, because I want to show you and I want to reveal what that 3M looks like So let's go take a look. So your boy Bonificent, and we out. All
right, YouTube. So without further ado, let's take at this 3M technology. Let's take a look at this and see how this kind of looks with 3M. So you're looking at a live view through my camera. And here we go. Let's turn this flash on and see what it... Ooh, wow. Oh, wow. Yeah, the tongue is 3M. You know, the PG3 logo on the tongue is 3M. Of course, this is the right side. It's the right foot right here. So we're looking at this, and yeah, just like I said, the eyelets right here. That's 3M. The side panel's 3M. This is a dope design, even on the inside. Now, the thing I do like about this is the fact that when you're looking at this shoe, not all of these, and I'll point this out on the when I look at this super enhanced, the super zoom video, you'll notice that not every single one of these parts of the stitching are all 3M. Because when I faded away, I think they did that purposely to have that like sort of like a speckle design on the 3M, or the reflective, I should say. And I think that that's pretty cool, because that's why, again, you'll see this when it's super enhanced, when I do that super zoom video. But I mean, if you look at the toe box is all reflective. This is the right shoe. So let's look at the left shoe. Yeah, the left shoe, I'd expect not this patching right here to be on the tongue to be reflective. So it's a patch. But anyway, when you look on, it's pretty much the same thing on this side. It's a little bit of 3M, I want to say on the Nike swoosh, but you really can't really see that. It's kind of, oh, I can't wait to see this magnified. But you do see it. The eyelets are 3M on this side as well. 3M on this side. 3M reflective on the toe box. And then you got the 3M reflective going around the heel of the shoe. This was well crafted. And of course, this is what I was talking about. You can see the RF chip right there. Get back in there. This is a welly. This is a well-designed shoe. That's interesting. Really interesting. But yeah, going back to here. Here we go right here. You know what? Quite honestly, this might actually be my... This might be my thumbnail. I might make this my thumbnail. I literally might make this the thumbnail. Just to show you, yo, these things are dope. Dope. Make sure I get that in there. Yeah, imagine that. Thumbnail just like this. Oh, man. That is dope. Anyway, just wanted to show you guys this. I think it's a pretty cool design. But without further ado, let's just get into the super zoom video so we can actually see what we're not seeing from the naked eye. YouTube, so let's just jump straight into the super zoom view of these PG3 NASAs. Of course, you've got the remove before flight tag 661 1990. We reviewed that, we know, but let's just look at the super zoom, because I wanted to see if there was any imperfections of this shoe. And quite frankly, I mean, look at the stitching. It is on point. It's on point. Now, when I look at this, I'm actually amazed at the details of this shoe. And you can see right there, even on the toe box itself, that nylon overlay, you can see the mesh enhanced like that. Again, you can't really see this with the naked eye. What is this? What am I looking at? Let me see here. What is this? Oh, okay. That's a part of the manufacture. That's not really... But that is dope. I mean, look at this. Keep this steady here. Oh, man. Now, I'm at the midsole of the shoe. This is a super enhanced version. Just trying to see, you can see, do not tell me the sky is, yeah, I know that saying, but we're looking at the midsole, and of course, this is back, if we flip this around. Now, this is super enhanced. Now, here's what I was talking about with that stitching. It looks like it has PG on the back, symbolizes the world, or is that the, yeah, it's got to be the world. That is pretty dope. So we're going to continue around the heel of the shoe. Look at the nylon effect on here. Come back around here. Man, this shoe is really, it is really detailed, but really dope at the same time, just to look at under the scope. And quite frankly, I am not displeased at all. Not displeased at all. So, with that said and done, actually, before we do that, I want to look at the bottom of the shoe. Take a look at the bottom, just look at it enhanced. And that is crazy. Look at the design on the Zoom, the Nike Zoom portion of the forefront of that foot right there. This is pretty dope. Now, I don't know what that is. My finger can get there. But again, was this worn? Oh, no, it's a part of the, that's interesting. But I can see it right there. And here we go. Didn't even see this. Can't see this with the naked eye. So that reads what? 2010. Interesting. I didn't even see that. I literally did not see that. Here's another one. We gotta find out what this stuff means right here. This is why I like the Superzoom, because he always has 5,290. That is interesting. I like them. I'm gonna do some research on that. Do some research on that to see what that is about, because that's interesting. I didn't really see that. Oh, there's another one. This one looks like it reads 405. But of course, we know 405 is the area code for OKC. Going back here, there goes the Paul George signature. And here's another one, 317. Interesting. There's the Nike Zoom. Obviously, you can see that. But yeah, these are actually filled with some type of numbers on the pods of the bottom of the shoe. So, your boy Magnificent, that Super Zoom version of the PG3 50th edition NASA reflectors. This is due out tomorrow, at least 10 a.m. if I'm not mistaken, on the sneakers app. But this is your first take and your first super zoom version of this. So with that said and done, let's just go straight into the on feed, and then we'll end it off.
Perfect.